U.S. forces shoot down another unidentified flying object in American airspace, this time over Michigan. The Pentagon said a fighter jet took down the object Sunday, which hovered over Lake Huron. It was a fourth downing by the U.S. in 8 days. The U.S. Air Force admits it has yet to identify what the three recent objects are and why they keep coming. The Pentagon said that while the latest object did not pose a military threat, it could have potentially interfered with U.S. air traffic. It also could have had surveillance capabilities. The death toll from the quake in Turkey and Syria, which continues to rise a week after the disaster struck. The fatalities from the tremors climbed to over 34,000, with chances of finding more survivors growing dim by the day. Turkish authorities have begun looking on who's to blame for the massive destruction. Reports say 131 people, including contractors, were arrested for their alleged role in the construction of the toppled buildings. Experts have warned in previous years many new buildings in Turkey were unsafe due to endemic corruption and poor government policies. U.S. President Biden flies to Poland next week to mark the anniversary of Russia's invasion of Ukraine. The White House says Biden's visit on February 20th is meant to reaffirm America's continued support for the war-hit country. Biden will also meet with the Polish president as well as leaders of Eastern European allies to discuss the situation in Ukraine. Filipino-American activists stage a protest in the U.S. to denounce the expanded defense cooperation between Manila and Washington. Our North America correspondent Steve Angeles reports.
Filipino-American activist group protested at the historic Filipino town Gateway in Los Angeles with a message that they oppose the Philippines becoming a gateway for the U.S. military.
Marcos Jr. is cementing deals that completely undermine the sovereignty of the Philippines and the long-term safety and security of the Filipino people. This is on top of the economic misery Filipinos have already been subject to.
Manila recently agreed to allow the U.S. military access to more military bases in the Philippines. It comes amid continuing maritime tensions between the Philippines and China in the West Philippine Sea and Chinese aggression over Taiwan.
We really have to think of it in a long-term and more comprehensive way. It's been years that we're in the middle of China and the U.S. Ultimately, what the Malaya movement wants is independent foreign policy so that we're not at the beck and call of any superpower or any of their geopolitical fights. Like, we are put in danger between these two countries, and U.S. bases is just a matter is escalating the danger that the Philippines is caught in between.
While it has been some 30 years since the last time America operated bases in the Philippines, one of its longest-running Asian allies, activists say military presence has a negative impact on the community.
Bases have been a historic breeding ground for violence against women and children, including the gang rape of Suzette Nicholas and the murder of our trans sister Jennifer Laude.
Other protests took place throughout the U.S., including New York, while activists have launched a petition to call for the U.S. and Philippines to cancel this agreement.
With Philippine officials expected to be in the U.S. a few weeks from now for the APEC summit, these protesters say they will continue rallying against the U.S. military presence in the Philippines. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.
Filipino Olympic boxer Yumir Marshall ends his first eight-round match quicker than expected. He knocked his Argentinian opponent out during Saturday's match in less than 4 minutes of action. Steve Angeles returns with that story.
It was supposed to be Yumir Marshall's first eight-round fight. Instead, it lasted a total of 3 minutes and 48 seconds as Marshall knocked out his opponent 48 seconds into the second round. The Tokyo Olympics bronze medalist defeated 33-year-old Argentinian Ricardo Ruben Villalba in San Antonio, Texas on Saturday night.
Masaya dahil yung mga pinaghirapan namin, training namin, the past 3 months, talagang lumabas sa laban.
Working behind a powerful jab, Marshall dropped the veteran fighter with a left body shot in the first round. Continuing to throw combos at the start of the second round, the referee called off the fight after Villalba went down early in the round.
Nagulat ka na bumagsak siya kaagad sa first round, then second round, 48 seconds lang. Nagulat ka ganun kadali.
Kasi lahat talaga namin, siguro yung power ko doon, mga 60%, 70% pa lang eh. Talaga, yung plan namin, doon ako magbibigay ng power sa third down, fourth down na. So, kung makapapansin nyo, mas more speed yung ginamit ko ng first down, second round.
While he executed his fight plan perfectly, Marshall admits the quick victory did deprive him of some valuable professional ring experience.
Yun talaga yung plan namin, makaroon pa ng experience. Talagang wala, hindi namin inisip na mananakal ka ganyan kasi talagang hindi din basta-basta yung kalaban natin, veteran. Makita nyo, talagang sa mga laban niya, 10 rounds, 12 rounds, matatapos talaga. So, sa isip ko, talaga makakaroon talaga ng experience dito dahil mahaba to yung laban namin.
The triumph now brings Marshall's professional record to 4 wins and 0 losses with 2 knockout wins. After being in the U.S. since last fall, he plans on taking a quick vacation to the Philippines. And he'll hit the gym again as his team considers his future plans, weighing in more fights and a possible return to the Olympics. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News.